everybody. So welcome to the number 20 episode of Wine, Women, and Song. I am Shonda, aka The Princess. I am currently waiting for our little rockabilly diva. I think hers was out just a little too late last night. Maybe she'll kiss and tell, who knows. Anyways, welcome. I will wait to crack open our booze for this week when she gets here. In the meanwhile, we are listening to one of my favorite records. This one's like an oldie, but it's Ricky Nelson, of course. Rick is 21. So many good tracks on here. I love this kind of early sound. So I hope you're enjoying that as well. And like I said, she will be here shortly, but I just did want to kind of hold off on the whole local booze thing. We do have a local wine that's awesome, and we'll be cracking that open shortly. And here she is. Yay! The Rockabilly Diva is in the house.
Oh my God, are you already recording?
Yes,
you're so crazy.
Yes. Well, yes. And I explained that you were out maybe a little too late or something, possibly. Sometimes it happens. You just need a little extra rest. Meanwhile, just wanted to say to everybody who's watching, happy Father's Day. We really appreciate our fathers. And my dad, he went and took himself to Toby Keith this weekend for Father's Day. I expect to see him a little bit later and get to spend some time with him. I'm very excited about that. But hopefully you're enjoying your Father's Day, whatever that means to you. If you're resting, if you're, you know, maybe throwing a ball around or sitting on the lake somewhere, I hope you're really having a wonderful, good time today. You deserve it. You earned it. And we appreciate all of the dads. There she is.
Hi.
Say hello.
Hi.
And this is
Eva, the Rockabilly Diva.
And she's here. So,
she's so on time. It's so good. She's never started without me before.
It's true. I was like, maybe she got lost. I don't know. She's only been here a bajillion times. Maybe she got lost. I don't know.
Traffic is crazy today, really. I think because
Father's Day. People are probably out and going out to brunch and... I hope that you are. I hope you're enjoying it. So yeah, I told him we are listening to Ricky Nelson.
Awesome.
I know, I love this one. He's so handsome. Anyways, and we do have a local wine. It is from Lodi. Voila, our little Vanna White over here. Very apropos, don't you think?
Naughty Divas.
Naughty Divas.
I love
divas.
That's awesome.
That's us, right?
Yes.
Yeehaw. So yeah, it's a Chardonnay. It is from Lodi. And I don't remember. I mean, is it Naughty Divas is the winery? Vinted and bottled by Naughty. That really is the name of the winery. It's not just the name of this wine. So I guess if you're in Lodi, go check out Naughty Divas.
Okay.
I know. And the cute pink, you know. We know who they're marketing this to, right? Chicks all the way.
It's not diet wine, is it?
What even is? Can I ask if you both waist train? Decolletage is amazing. She's got the boob game on lock. I can't compete with this boob game that she's got going on.
I do waist train.
Yeah. So she's got it going on with that. I sometimes will wear like shapers and stuff, but I don't have a corset and I'm not into that kind of pain.
It's not painful.
Okay. Anyone who's worn a corset probably, I used to go to Renaissance fairs back in my nerdy goth days and I remember having, you know, like this, and I remember that, but, it is a little bit painful, but thank you, Stacey, and thank you so much for watching. We appreciate you being here. And, as always, if you are enjoying a little beverage,
I'm like, what was I thinking?
Cheers to you and happy Sunday. Cheers. Looks like there's like almost bubbles in it. Weird.
And it smells kind of fruity.
Whoa. Are you sure it's not, like, diet wine, huh? I don't drink Chardonnays, though, so I don't even know what a Chardonnay tastes like. You love
it? Nice. Mm-hmm.
Yeah? Okay.
I like it. I like a good white wine, something.
Like my beers, I like dark, 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 dark wine. So I like really dark reds, like Malbecs and Merlot. Kind of basic, but I like a really dark red wine. But, you know, hot summer day, cold white wine, kind of refreshing, you know. But usually if I'm going to drink something lighter, I will go for the bubbles. I'll do like a champagne.
I usually drink white wine in the
summer. That's your jam, huh? Yeah, so.
If I drink wine.
Yes.
Because I'm more beer.
More of a beer chick. Yeah, totally.
You don't keep this girlish figure drinking wine.
That's the secret to the boobs.
All the wine.
All the beer.
Beer.
Yeah. So, yeah, gosh, what a week, huh? Did we have a great week or
what? Oh my god, so good.
You've been a busy gal, too.
I have. Well, I wasn't very busy Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday.
Well, but then you made up for it later.
I made for it.
Yeah.
I made up for it. For
yes.
Sure.
And we had a really good time last night. I didn't actually get to go to a whole lot of music shows this week. You know, last week of school for the kiddos, they're out now for the summertime. Mm-hmm. So I didn't get a whole lot of music in just because I'm like, you know, just that last week is just kind of hectic, you know, just everybody, I don't want to go to school. That whole, you know, if you're a parent, you know what I'm talking about. That just, the drudgery of that last week is kind of hardcore to get through. But did have a wonderful weekend. Spent some time with my nephew this weekend.
Yeah.
And went to a fantastic, really great show. It was very unexpected, I think, for me, because we went out and saw the Earls of Newtown. I think mm-hmm. I'm saying that right. I don't know if they say mm-hmm. Newton or Newtown.
Yeah.
But they are amazing. They're so awesome. It was such a great show. I super duper extra recommend
super
this band.
If, fun.
Oh my gosh. So
it's like gypsy jazz.
Yes.
A little bit of Zydeco mixed in.
And funk. Out of nowhere, there's a little funk.
A little bit of New Orleans, like,
kind of Dixieland jazz. And just such a great mix of sounds and styles. And then some of the vocals, like the fellow that we got to meet last night, Chad. One of the singers in the band, because they kind of all take
turns.
He plays the washboard.
So cool.
But he's got that really gravelly, good, like Tom Waits kind of sound in his voice. So I super extra really enjoyed. Like, I loved their whole everything.
Yeah.
It was just so good.
So good.
But I guess they don't get down to the flatland too much. They're up there in Nevada City. They don't come down to Sacramento too often. But like I said, if you get a chance, if you're up in this area, if you see that they're playing anywhere, I super recommend seeing them. They are very entertaining. They have a horn section. I'm a big sucker for horns. I love that
horn section.
And just a really super great fun, like, party band. Everybody was dancing and having a good time.
See, I haven't really been able to explore.
That's a great photo.
Yeah,
what good packaging and marketing and whatnot. Really good branding and stuff.
I mean, even this one in the back.
Yeah,
so good.
Yeah, how cool.
Okay. Well, I haven't been able to listen to the CD yet, but because I just got it last night before I left. But
we got to see it live.
Excellent. Yeah. So I'm sure the CD is just as amazing. I mean,
I'm sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, so good.
So that was fun.
That was really fun.
Okay, so let me tell you on a side note. So you left a little early mm-hmm. before their last set, and there was this old fella. I don't know if you saw him. He had the bow tie. Older gentleman with a Latina woman. They were sitting behind my friend. Anyway.
Okay.
He ended up falling and hitting his head on the ground
Oh, no.
because he was dancing. He's pretty drunk, though. You know, Torch
Ooh,
Club people.
Torch Club times. You get a little tipsy up in there.
And my friend was dancing with him, one of my friends from Sacktown Swings, and she was like, oh my god, he did this, he turned me around and then he spun around and then he just tripped over himself, basically. So
Ooh, scary.
We had the firefighters there.
Ooh la la, we do love some firefighters.
I was all, thank you for bringing the firefighters out.
Sorry you cracked your head, but
the guy was okay. They walked him out. He was joking when they walked
good.
Out, but they did take him to the hospital. I mean, he's
just
like
to check
80.
Him out. Yeah.
He was like 80. I think they said he was 89 or something
God
like that.
God bless him. God bless him. We love that
guy.
Yeah.
So,
Oh my god. So there was like a shenanigans after
There was
enough.
Shenanigans.
Holy cow. Well,
shenanigans.
So the point was you got to see sexy firefighters at the show last night as an added bonus, as if the music wasn't enough. That's awesome.
Yeah. But the band did stop as soon as they saw that he was hurt, and then they kind of started once he left. So I think they played a little later than they would have.
Okay.
But I left, right? I bought a CD and left. I said that was my time to go.
Yo. Okay. Wow, what a full evening. But yeah, that it was a fun show other than, you know, people. I know it is a little warm.
Oh,
huh?
I'll be right back.
It's it's actually cooler. We've been having some 100 degree days.
I know.
You ought to just like that's my little chihuahua is begging outside, and crazy. And yeah, she's, we call her in and out the window because she's like in and out, in and out, in and out, in and out, in and out all day. That's like what she does. Anyway, and she can't stand that I'm in here and I might have like scrambled eggs or something in here. And, you know, maybe. She's funny. Anyway, so yeah, fun times. And then you went to a couple other shows this week also.
I did.
Now, did you catch music at Arthur Henry's? Because I saw you went there.
I did go there.
Was there music too?
They have music every Friday.
Yeah.
8 to 10.
Because I think Mindy from Swell Productions was there.
Oh,
because I think I saw her post something about, this is the closest I can get to Chicago nightlife. Thank you, Sacramento.
It was jazz.
Yep.
That night.
Yep.
But, I went to Sackyard first, but we won't talk about that yet. So I went to see this great band. A friend I'm not going to say a friend. Now he's a friend, I guess. But he works at Harlow's.
Uh-huh.
And I go to a lot of shows at Harlow's, whether they're...
We love Harlow's.
It doesn't matter what the music is. If they have a punk show, a indie show, whatever. So he suggested this band, and I was like, I don't know. He's like, they're like a surf band. And yeah. I was like, oh, let me look them up. And I'm like, they're not like a surf band, but they are.
Nice.
So they are called the Buttertones, and they are from Los Angeles. I had to support. They didn't have any albums. They do have them online, though. Anyway, they are amazing. They are adorable. They dress... Absolutely. You know, we always say dress the part.
Style. We love,
dress,
you know, when you dress
make
up
sure,
in a style.
Yeah, don't wear t-shirts and jeans and,
I mean,
like,
yeah. like
you know.
Put yourself
like,
together.
Oh, my
stage.
God. They have, like, a cool 50s style. They're young. They're beautiful, beautiful boys.
Mm-hmm.
Young men, I should say, because I think the oldest one is, like, 30-something.
Okay.
They all have their individual style, but very cool.
That's awesome.
You know, rolled up jeans.
Yeah, I enjoyed
everything.
The videos.
So
that you were posting.
They are, their influences are like the Cramps, some surf music.
So it's a little garagey, little rock and roll.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
I also felt like they were, I don't know, they were so fun. I can't describe it. It was such a good time.
That's so
and
good.
They were super nice
it
at
looked
the end.
Like
because,
a
of
really
course,
good
I had
show.
To get a photo
it looked
with
like it
them.
Packed.
It was packed.
They're
but it was an all ages
deal, right?
show as
yeah.
well.
Yeah, oh, that, and that's rare at Harlow's. They don't have a lot of all ages shows. So
I don't mind an all ages show.
Yeah, it's okay.
I really don't.
It's nice to mix
but,
up.
But wow,
just
I mean,
so many people,
so many teenagers.
Yeah.
Sometimes I just can't with that.
That speaks a lot to though. You know, I was just talking to the daughter person today.
Yes.
She's trying to put together a little punk rock show. So if you are into the punk rock and you want to help out my teenage daughter, she's trying to. Poor thing. I'm like, really, don't be like your mom. Don't put on shows. But she insists on doing it. So I know I can't stop her no more than my mother could stop me.
Yeah.
That's just the way it is. But she's reached out to Danny Secretion.
Mm-hmm.
And they're looking to put something together either at the Colony or
okay.
The Colonial
yeah.
Cafe.
Yeah.
One of those two venues. Something
still very
all
cool
ages.
Places. They've changed it a little
mm-hmm.
from what it was.
And Danny said he's yeah. going to try to help her secure the venue. But anyway, she's recently gotten into Los Crudos. I'm getting a little off topic here, which I apologize. But she's been into like this really like hardcore metal and like crazy hardcore punk.
Mm-hmm.
And so she wants to cultivate a show that maybe showcases some bands around here. But she said like most of the punk bands in Sacramento that she has contact with, I mean, maybe there's some that we don't know about, mm-hmm. but they're all kind of like poppy, like
pop,
in the
punk.
Vein of like a
yeah.
Green Day kind of a sound. Mm-hmm. So she's like, oh, but anyway, getting back to where I was going with all of this is that there's just a lack of teenage venues. Like
yes.
we have Silver Orange, which we always try to love and support and shout out the Silver Orange, the Colony,
Colonial
Cafe, and then occasionally at Harlow's. So yeah, sometimes when you have an all ages show like that, it's just packed to the gills because mm-hmm. those poor kids don't have anywhere to go. They just don't have anywhere, you know.
Yeah.
And I think that, thank goodness, some of the club promoters do recognize when they need to have an all-ages show because, hi, this band has a fan base that's,
yep.
you know, younger. So
we're looking at each other instead of talking to you. That's so weird. Like, we're having our own conversation. Sorry, that was just weird. I just was like, I'm all, yeah, really.
This is what we do, and you are welcome to join us.
There's a lot of
Sunday silliness today, so sorry, you guys. But anyway, so, you know, we wish that there could be more of, like, all ages shows.
I mean,
like,
we had it. I had it. I got
we
to
totally
go to
did.
Dance clubs no, we and were, whatever.
We, you know what? I have to say, like, living in Sacramento, 80s, 90s, we did. As a young kid, we had lots of options for, I mean, pretty much 3-4 nights a week.
Yep.
To go somewhere and see a band or DJ.
Dance,
just, you know, just social dance, get together, do a thing. And unfortunately, that's just not the way. Nice. But I mean, all of our music venues in general we're really losing our music venues.
And that's a totally different topic.
Yes, it is. And on that, I drink.
Yeah, and change the music.
Do we want to listen to The Other Side of Rick?
So we should. Yeah, I think so. So, anyway, this was my Thursday night. She didn't go. I think sometimes I try to get Shonda to go to stuff that I go to that she might not really know.
Which I love. I love that.
But sometimes, you know, she is a mother, too. So, I mean, I can't expect her to go out with me all the time.
Things are going to get easier now, though, because kids are out of school. Yeehaw!
And then on Friday, I wasn't going to go out Friday. I really wasn't. Whoops. I was exhausted. And
look, it's Abby. Hi, Abby. Hi.
Thank you. I went to the Sack Yard, which is one of our local
favorites. Yeah. Yes, we love Sack Yard.
They do outdoor music, and when it's rainy, it's indoor. It's a little bit tight, but it's still good.
Hey, they're putting on live music, and they're paying bands, and I support that so much, and I'm so appreciative. And it's just always a good time.
That's right.
That's my little...
Her catchphrase.
Yes. Lately. I don't know. But they always do a good job of, like, you know, showcasing our local talent. They always have a full music calendar. We really appreciate them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I went to go see our pals, the
Our
Hufflepuff.
Boys. Yeah. We love
and,
them.
And so they were amazing, as always. Usual.
Yep.
And my good pal, Ronnie James, he played on this CD with a kid that basically it's his nephew. But he's from Nashville, Tennessee.
The drummer guy?
That's Jason.
Okay.
He's the drummer for JD McPherson.
His
son is a blues musician. He is 17. I think he's turning 18 soon. Mm-hmm. He tours. He does his own thing. His dad plays drums for him. And Ronnie, last summer, played bass, and then they made this album.
Nice.
So, I had the live in Nashville, Tennessee, like, EP that he sent for me last year.
So cool.
So, this year, I got the new McKinley James CD. Super excited. Thank you, McKinley. But it's really great.
Cool. And this is all blues, yeah?
It's blues. He's a little, like, he mixes it up a little bit. He is, wow, for a kid.
So good.
He's so good. So good.
That's awesome.
And he played at Nashville Boogie this year. And
fabulous.
Our good pal, Shanda, took some video and I was like, oh my god, she was like, this guy is amazing, and I'm like, yay, I'm so glad that you love McKinley. So McKinley James, look him up, he's on Instagram, and he's got a new CD out, and if you're into the blues, and it is a little bit blues, and then a little bit kind of, you can dance to some of it, swing,
okay.
So maybe swing blues a little bit, just,
a little jump blues
So I like it. I love it. And I'm so grateful that he sent
I'll
one
have to check that out.
For
Exciting.
Me.
Wait, so now you saw this kid play? No, you got this at the Hucklebucks. You went to the Hucklebucks, okay.
And my friend, gotcha. Ronnie brought it for me. Ronnie James brought it for me because he's like, I got McKinley's new CD.
Because our friends know that when they go anywhere, they best be bringing us some musical souvenirs.
Yes.
I think the word is out. Like,
yes.
If you love us, you bring us music.
Yes.
Because there's just no better souvenir than, like, a new record, a new CD, something maybe we haven't heard. Maybe it's something we already really love, but it's always very appreciated. We really appreciate
So McKinley
that.
Sent him two, one for
How
him,
cool.
one for me, and I'm, like, super grateful for that.
Yeah.
I will support
so
this
cute.
Kid.
And
forever.
The Hucklebucks were amazing. Like
the Hucklebucks were amazing. Yes.
Yeah, that's a great local band also. You know, that's one of those little local treasures. You kind of wish you could share it more with the world just because they really are so good, so seasoned, so talented.
They are a blues band.
Yep.
But they do a little bit of jump swing as well. And then They throw in some other random stuff.
Well, and then there's just, it's such an all-star.
They play to their crowd, I think.
Too. Yeah, they do. I think they do, too. They can do anything.
They can.
And they do.
So that's our good pal, Doug James. And then there's Ronnie James. And then Kenny. And Robert Sidwell actually sat in for a couple of songs. Yay.
Love Robert.
We love Robert.
Yeah, we do.
And I always forget the drummer's name, though.
Oh.
It's so bad. I'm so horrible.
I'm horrible with names, period.
Yeah.
Like, I have to meet you like
50
times.
But I've known Doug, Ronnie, Kenny, and Robert for like, since I was like in my early
20s. Well, yeah, no, Doug Krempacker has been doing this stuff since like, I don't even know, the beginning of time. He's amazing. We love him. We love him.
We love him.
And we love the Hucklebucks.
Yes,
so.
We do.
Well, that's awesome.
So that was fun. So that was my musical
week. Journey.
Yeah.
Journey this week. That's awesome.
So, and I'm glad that I got to support some of these bands and like the Buttertones and pick up a few things. I got a few things for her daughter too because I'm a good mom.
She's a good mom. The other mother.
I am the other mother.
Yeah. My daughter loves her.
Yeah. So I can't wait to give it to her later. So that'll be fun.
Oh yeah. And she's here. So
I know.
Yay. So, what else?
I didn't take any notes.
I didn't really take any notes either. I think I've been, this whole last week, I've been pretty myopic on, you know, let me just bore you to tears again, but we have, this is like one of the biggest shows that we have in Sacramento, in the area, period, end of story. This is like a giant musical event, and it's, you know, just, it's been so much work, and it's what we're doing, currently. Yeah! No, sharesy wearsies. So this is the flyer for this year's Dads and Nostalgic, and I know we've talked about it a few times over the course of the last few weeks. It is next weekend. I don't know how.
Yes.
It's all of a sudden, it just feels like, boom, it's here.
I want this to be amazing, and I know it will be, and come and see us.
I feel like in the last couple of weeks, we've really picked up a lot of steam. I've been getting a lot of inquiries. We've gotten a couple more sponsors. Atomic Beauty has jumped on board with like sponsoring the pinup contest.
Awesome.
We have Pinup Girl Photography sponsoring the pinup contest. The pinup contest in of itself is like a whole show in of itself. Like, it's worth the price of admission. My hair flower's slipping. Look, I'm slipping. It's like doing a thing. It's all wiggly. Anyhow, so that's going to be amazing. The pinup contest, we have 14 or 15 contestants currently. I think we have room for like one more. We also have Boomerang Betty's, which is our favorite local jewelry company.
Yes.
She's been so great and so kind and generous with all of our endeavors and everything we do. She's very supportive. But she sponsored the sashes for this year, and they're just gorgeous. I don't know if I want it to be a surprise or if I want to tell everybody, but she did these amazing black satin sashes with like silver font and silver glitter, and they're gorgeous.
So the pinup theme is
Hollywood starlet.
Yeah.
So we're looking for super glammy glam, 19, you know, silver screen. So like, you know, 30s through 60s silver screen style Hollywood glamour.
Yay.
No,
so
I still don't even know what I'm going to wear. That's the crazy thing.
I don't either. I'll probably just wear one of my regular dresses.
I'm kind of feeling like, even though it's like the pin, I'm not in the pinup contest.
I mean, a crown.
You could wear a tiara.
Ooh.
Princess wave.
Yes.
I was feeling like, you know, something kind of more on the country tip, just because I love that country vibe that's at the Wrangler Bar. So yeah, it's next weekend, June 22nd. We're going to be at the Wrangler Bar in Elk Grove. We have amazing musical lineup, all day music. We have the DJ, Big Daddy Ray out in the parking lot doing his thing.
Good.
He's really good. He has a really good eclectic mix of music and a really great musical knowledge. So I know he's just going to really be tearing it up out in the parking lot with the cars.
Love it.
So good.
Yeah,
and
so come and support him also, because it might be hot that day and he's going to be out there.
In the lot. We've got the big shady tree in the lot out there for him. But yeah, we have barbecue out on the patio with the Burgess Brothers barbecue.
About that.
And then, just music all day long. We have, you know, Pope Paul and the Illegals are coming up from LA. We have Roy Justice, our favorite.
Love Rory.
We love him so much. And he's been so supportive of the show, and we just adore him for that.
Yeah.
Blender Bombs,
we love them.
They're so good, like Surf Spy, instrumental kind of a band. Super fun, very entertaining, not a boring instrumental band.
Yeah.
Really fun instrumental
really
band.
Fun.
So they'll be there. The Fortunate Few, those are our homies.
Yep.
We love them.
That's a Western
swing, vintage country.
Yeah.
You know, you might hear a little Merle, you might hear some George Jones, you might hear some Lefty Frizzell. he really mixes it up. Hank Williams, he nails it like nobody nails it, like Mike nails it. So it's really good. You'll be able to dance all day long. Bring your dancing shoes. Yep. They have a hardwood dance floor out at the Wrangler Bar, so it's just gonna be fun. But anyway.
Oh wait, and Elvis Cantu.
Yes, let's not forget our home slice, Elvis Cantu. I love him.
Yes, Elvis.
He's got some really good new songs too. He's just been chopping that wood, just getting some good songs together. I'm so excited.
I know. So good. He doesn't know if he wants to call it the dance song or the other name that.
Oh yeah, you were like.
Yeah, I love that
like,
song.
I'm all. But he wrote that other one. That, did you see the video with Zach?
Yes. So good.
You know, I was watching that video and I was thinking to myself, Elvis Cantu and Zach Sapinor are just like a show by themselves.
It could just be them.
Literally. It could be like a duo. It's so good. Hi, Heather. Hi, honey. It's nice to see you. Thank you for joining us. Time for more vino, por favor. Drinky drink.
I feel like, how come there's only like...
Yeah, these glasses are ginormous, though. I mean, honestly, look at how big these
wine glasses are.
They're good because they're big.
Anyway, this is what we're drinking, if you missed it.
Naughty Divas from Lodi.
Yes, it's from Lodi. Locally.
That is local.
From Lodi. Yeah, and it's a Chardonnay, and it's delicious. It's a good summer wine.
I feel like we've been having so many, like, Lodi wines, so we really need to take, like, a trip to Lodi and go visit some of these places.
We should. But I think next week, I think I'm going to do this other cider company.
It's good. Oh, not Ace. Because the Ace cider was so good.
No, it's different.
Okay. I'm so excited.
I can't wait. I need to just find this one that I really want us to try.
Yeah, that pineapple one was off the chain. So good.
Anyway.
So... Well, on the Elvis Cantu tip, I did want to shout out, we did go there last week, which I know we talked about a little bit last week, to Elvis's beautiful Tiki in the Pines.
Yes.
And had a wonderful little stay up there, a nice party under the gorgeous pine trees with our friends, and being silly, listening to music. We had an ukulele sing-along. It was super, super, super fun. But our pal JT... also a very big supporter of all things Shonda and Eva. He's just been so good to us.
And Elvis.
He brought me a very special souvenir. We were talking about musical souvenirs. From Viva Las Vegas this year. Look what he got me. I'm so excited. Look at this. So Tammy Savoy is like, she is like seriously like my new favorite. Like, I know I have a bajillion favorites and they're all my favorite, but I love Tammy Savoy. And, you know, I haven't had the fortune of seeing her live quite yet. I'm hoping to change that very soon.
We almost did.
I begged her to come to NorCal.
But we also almost went to LA.
True. But to the Santa Ana show.
Yeah, but we didn't for some reason.
Dude, we've been busy.
She was probably like... I don't want to go.
I'm crying.
All weekend. That's what she does sometimes.
I'm depressed.
We love LA though.
We love to go to shows in LA. We love our LA friends. Yes. But anyway, this little gal right here, you guys, I'm here to tell you, she's a meteor. She is a shooting star. She is dynamite. She is of another era. She is, I can't even put it into words. I'm like, she's God's gift. She's amazing. But anyway, I was really stoked to get this little 45 to add to my collection because... You guys know sometimes we also go out and DJ events, and so I'm definitely going to put this in my regular rotation.
Yay.
And thank you, JT, because I really appreciate it. But once again, you guys, like when you go on trips and stuff, you know, your friends like records. Well, we do anyway. If they don't like records, you can send them to us. It's okay. But it was a very nice present, and I really appreciate it.
Awesome.
That one's yours.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, cool.
So.
Yes.
Exciting. Okay, I know. So what else? Oh my God. I feel like I did so much this weekend. Oh, and it was a lot cooler this weekend.
Thank God.
Today's hotter, though.
I think it's supposed to be like close to 90. Like,
yeah, and it was like nice yesterday.
It was like, I just wanted to be outside all day yesterday. It was so beautiful. Yes. Of course, I spent most of it in my car.
I spent most of it in bed. I needed one of those days. You know, do you ever have one of those days where you just like don't want to do anything?
Yep.
Well, I did that.
That's awesome.
I needed it.
I love that.
I really needed it.
I feel like, because you really do burn it down. You really are the gal on the go. She works all the time. When she's not working, she's out cutting it up somewhere with somebody, doing something. She's a busy gal. So we really...
And I'm not even a musician or anything. I'm just like...
We're just rabid fans.
Yeah.
Rabid fans. We love it. So yeah, I mean, sometimes you just need to take a little personal day and refresh and recharge. And
so, do you have any notes on anything coming up?
No.
You don't?
No.
I don't feel like, besides this, I think there's a couple of other things that weekend, but I didn't even...
Changing the music.
What are we putting on now?
I don't know. What do you want to hear?
I don't know.
I picked out some things. You know what I picked out? I've been on kind of like a 60s kind of a deal lately, like 60s and 70s.
I almost bought
the hard grooves. Like, I've just been really into, like, you know, the garage and, like, just really, I don't know. So, anyway.
I almost brought the Delta Bombers because all of my friends in Seattle and Delta Bombers' first ever show in Canada.
Oh, yeah, they're in Canada.
Last night or
was
Friday
Corey there?
Night.
Corey, did you go?
I don't know because my friends that live in Vancouver, they had to drive down a little bit.
Okay.
From wherever they live.
Wait,
in
so where did they play?
You know what? I forget. Okay. But they were super excited because they're like, the Delta Bombers never come
if
to Canada.
If they're coming from Vegas up to Canada, that means that they should be able to stop through Sacramento.
We just saw them, though, didn't we?
Well,
we didn't just
see them.
I know.
Again.
So I almost brought their record because I was like, oh, what a cool thing because they're, you know, touring and my friends are, like, seeing them right
How
now.
Cool.
Like, so, Seattle and then Canada, so.
Nice.
Yeah. Anyway.
That's exciting. Congratulations, Delta Bombers.
Yeah, yay.
That's way cool.
That doesn't make them international, though, does it?
Is it
international when you go to Canada?
They're hella international.
I know they're hella international.
Yeah.
But does Canada?
Well, yeah, because it's not the U.S. Who's the blonde here? Which one is the blonde?
I'm super bad about that kind of stuff.
We're gonna have to swap our hair colors.
Yes, totally.
Anyways, this is the Yardbirds, you guys. Yardbirds.
Oh, awesome.
This is Shapes of Things. This is like a whole... It's a collection 64 through 1966. Look at these sexy lads. Look at them. Oh, my God. I love them.
Yes.
I really love the Yardbirds. Anyway, so yeah, we'll just rock and roll.
See, and we do, like, again, we don't just listen to, like, rockabilly or blues or, like, you know... We listen to a little bit of everything, you know. So
and we like it all.
We
like it all.
So, okay, so I have a little thing that I would like to... You know, sometimes we talk about girl things or, like...
It's true.
You know,
not too
topics.
Loud. I feel like that's too loud.
So loud.
Oh, my God, it's so loud.
So, I have to say that I'm a little bit of a grudge holder. I'm just going to be honest. And
This is gonna be good. Get comfortable, get your drink. Okay. It's gonna be good.
So this week a gal messaged me privately on Messenger, and I'm not a friend of hers, but she's a friend
mutual friend
yes,
yeah,
of multiple of
friends.
My friends.
She's in our little clique.
So years ago she said a few things on different occasions, and it just rubbed me the wrong way, and I'm like, I will never be friends with this girl. She's so mean.
You get one chance with Eva. Don't F it up.
Like,
don't F it.
But it was like multiple things to friends of mine, and,
right.
And they would say it.
And she's very fiercely protective of her pals, too.
Yeah.
Also. That's very true.
So I was just like, I will never be friends with this girl. And but then, I'm just like, whatever. It doesn't matter because I have the people that I want around me to be around me. So, I got a message this week, and she apologized for whatever...
It's Amy.
Hi, Amy.
Hi.
Amy Cantu.
Cantu.
And she apologized for whatever... She doesn't know what she's done, but she did apologize.
That's
because
great.
She just wanted to,
kind of
you know,
it
yeah, put it out yeah. there and release it into the atmosphere and get it over with for whatever reason, which I totally accepted that. I haven't messaged her back, but... I guess if she's watching, I accept your apology.
Good.
And she did say something like, you know, not everybody has to like us and we don't have to be friends and I don't expect much out of this, but you know, I just want to let you know that I apologize and I'm saying that I accept her apology. And sometimes you're right. We don't all have to like each other, but if we have mutual friends,
what?
We probably
That's
should
cool.
keep our snooty comments.
That's true. And
to
listen,
ourselves.
as girls, listen,
we're pretty catty.
We are born and bred and raised to like automatically hate each other, and it's hideous. It's hideous. Yeah. It's really bad. Like, it's I catch myself do it too. I mean, I'll say things and my daughter will be present and I'll be like, yeah, that was a bitchy thing to say. I shouldn't have said that. Because, you know what? Like, really, it's hard enough to be a chick on the planet already. It's already hard enough. Like, we don't need to make it harder for each other. And sometimes things do slip out and you say things and maybe it's your own insecurity talking.
And that's what I feel like that might have been back in the day. Which I thought, well, why? I'm nobody. Like, I'm nothing. I'm like, why
don't
would
say
you
say that? I'm going to punch her in the face.
Well, no, honestly, because, you know, I was just getting out of a marriage and going through my own shit. And I was just kind of coming back into meeting people. And I was not, I didn't feel great because, I guess, because of the marriage thing, like the failure.
You know, when you come out of a relationship, so, you're a little vulnerable. You feel very
So I was just trying to be nice and meet people, and I felt like the first
reception
meeting,
was not nice.
So, and it happened on more than one occasion, and so I just kind of said, well, I don't need that. Right? Because we don't. And yes, you're right, we are catty, but I'm a grudge holder. And I'm trying not to be as much. But
no,
I have two
sisters. Up in the house.
But I also have two sisters, and they could be like super sweet, and sometimes they're just awful. Mm-hmm. And I think because we're all girls, and then you have girlfriends, like, I would not let my girlfriends treat me that way. Like,
but you're
they would not be my friends any longer.
Also. You also have to have standards. No, that's 100%, and so. You're right about that. And that's funny, you know, it's funny because I feel like we're right now, both of us are kind of going through a thing. It's like a reckoning, you know, that happens.
Absolutely.
Like, everything comes around, everything goes around, and then comes back in. And I feel like we're kind of both going, you know, through some things that are like, oh, hi, you're back. Oh, hi. Yep. And they're just like, and it's interesting, you know, human relations, but I feel like for myself, like the things that have happened recently for me, it's more along the lines of just, it's a life lesson. Like, we're all here to learn. That's what we're here for. And, you know, forgiveness and a capacity to understand and to be accepting, it's huge. Like, we all have to, like, try. It's hard. But, you know, maybe that inspires you to go out there and bury some grudge, because grudges are stupid. And at the end of the day, nobody wins. Like, you feel shitty because you're holding a grudge. They feel shitty because they feel like they've slighted you in some way and they feel like they can't repair it or fix it. And it's, nobody wins.
Well, some
nobody
people
wins.
Don't feel that
well, listen,
way.
But those people are going to approach you and say, hey, I did something and I'm sorry.
Right, but
I'm talking about people that are willing to come forward and say, I fucked up and I'm sorry. And I don't want this between us anymore.
You can cuss on this show.
I just did.
I saw. You're like. But, and I feel like when you hold, like, I wasn't holding any, like, super anger. I was just like, well, I can avoid this person.
Yep, easy.
Like, you know, easy for me. But, like, when you, like, I just recently had some issues with my sisters. And I felt like it was making me not feel well. And I feel like when you hold in that negative energy, it just makes you feel ill. And and it can turn into worse stuff the longer you hold it in. And I'm a true believer in, like, you know, you're souring your, like, blood. You're souring your system.
Negativity. Yes. Negativity.
So
negativity.
You have to release it.
Yeah.
You know,
to let it go.
Let it go. Release it.
And that's hard,
too.
I'm Capricorn. I've got hooves firmly in the ground. It's hard for me to let shit go. It's really hard. I mean, yeah. You
but
know.
Sometimes it's not so hard for her.
What are you saying? I'll just cut your shit off. I will cut you off, but I will also let you back. That's the truth.
Yes.
I mean, I'm very forgiving. I mean, I will blow my top. I will lose my crap for a while. I will be, like, not okay for a while. And it does, you know, it's like, it's one of those things. It's like, you get a chance, you get another chance, you get another chance, you get another chance, you get another. And I will. I'll go all down the line. And then all of a sudden, it's like something just clicks, and I'm like, you're dead to me. But at the end of the day, it's like I was saying, it's like, I don't want to hold grudges. I don't want to be that person that's like, it's too much energy to, like, freaking hate people and be angry. It's just too much energy.
Absolutely.
And I don't have time for that. I have really magical good things to do, like, fun things to do. And that's what I want to concentrate on. Yeah. You girls, you know what I'm talking about, right? Heather, Amy, you know what I'm talking about. Yep. So, yeah, just, you know, you just have to, like.
So, to that gal, I accept your
apology
and, you know.
Yeah. That's good.
If we see each other again, that's huge because I probably won't be as avoidy.
Because listen, I love all my girlfriends. I love her. I really love you, Mike, so much. I love Eva. This gal, she's like a gift in my life. I'm gonna start crying. I love this girl so much. I
Let's
love
go to
her.
Learn signs and cry.
Okay, Monica. She's a bitch too. I love it. Oh my god. Anyway, I love this girl. So, you know, it is I you know, in a perfect world you just want everybody to get along. That's the story. That's what you hope for.
We are a small community and there's a lot of us that know each other. And so yeah, it is kind of tough when maybe someone had a falling out and then you're kind of on their side too, but you've already had bad blood with that person and you're just like, well, I'm not going to let this, your friend, get back into that because I felt like it was negative or whatever. Like, so it's easy to kind of be overprotective.
But you are, to that end, you're a very good judge of character.
You have, like, radar.
Well, we both suck at that. Let's be real. We both suck. It's okay. But I'm saying I trust what you say because I feel like you have a very good sense about people. Sometimes I'm too open and I'm too like, oh yeah, you're my best friend. Yeah. Like, you're great. And like, you're really like, you see things that like not everybody sees. You've got some street sense, I think. I feel like.
It's the
Eva appreciation party.
I love this song, by the way.
I did too. I love Yardbirds. I love, like, yeah. Makes me want to see Chris Sprague, though, right?
Oh, yeah, totally.
I can't wait. Oh, that's what I should talk about. I should talk about this.
Okay, so we're done with the friends and the love and the whole,
I know.
Whatever, heart. Wait, I can't do
the
it.
The drama.
Hold on.
The drama.
Yes. So anyway, let's all try to be kinder to each other. I think that's kind of the goal in life.
Preferably.
And, yeah.
Be nice, be sweet, be kind. Yeah. Make magic. Make magic every day, because you can. I wanted to talk about, in July, very possibly, it's not confirmed, I have the, Chris Sprague is a good pal. You know, I mean, I've loved him for a long, long time. I love him a long time. I love every band he's in. I love everything he does. I think he's like the world's best drummer ever. Hands down, the best is Chris Sprague ever. But more than a drummer, the guy can play guitar, he can sing, he can write songs, he can just do everything. And he can dance, sugar balls, dance.
Yes, he can.
He's amazing. I love Chris Sprague. Anyway, he had about 8 or so years ago, he brought up an act up to Northern California called the 18 Wheelers. And they're a honky-tonk, Bakersfield, country, vintage country, that truck driving sound, right? That's what they did. And love, love, love. They were so, so good. And I love them. And he kind of just, like, retired that. And he got really involved with, like, you know, he was obviously, you know, playing with Zeke Dickerson. He was playing, you know, now with the Low Straitjackets. He was out of sights, really took precedence. So he wasn't doing the 18 Wheelers anymore. So it's been about 8 years, which is so crazy because it feels like yesterday. But he's putting the band back together. He's putting the 18 Wheelers back together. Yay. And he's supposed to come up here in July. And I'm actively working on a venue and getting the details together. The date that I've been given is July 12th. But you know what? Let's all get our country on and like let's just all dress up and go out and see the 18 Wheelers when they come up.
I think that would be amazing.
This new lineup is also going to feature Mitch Pulzak, which if you don't know Mitch Pulzak, he is an amazing, one of the world's best pickers ever, guitar picker. He's just incredible. You've seen him at Viva Las Vegas, Guitar Geek Festival. He is going to be in the mix with Chris Sprague, so hopefully I will by next week have some announcements regarding that show and you guys will all come out and support it. It's going to be really good.
Yes. We love Chris.
We do.
I'd like to see him in that kind of, he's over there in Europe right now.
Yeah, yeah.
I'd love to see him in that kind of like country honky tonk.
He nails everything. He's like a human jukebox. The guy's like rockabilly, yes. 60s, yes. Country, yes. Like he can do anything. He's amazing. Totally.
Love him.
Yep, me too.
It's amazing. So I'm just like trying to see what's going on next week. I guess we'll kind of like run through a bit of that and then kind of wrap it up at the end with like,
okay.
you know, we'll talk a little bit more about dads and stuff like that. Or like,
okay,
this is what's going on, blah, blah, blah.
Okay.
So next Friday, the 21st, at the Royal Cuckoo Organ Lounge. Is it an organ lounge now? I didn't know
Apparently.
That. Anyway, our good friend, LeVay Smith, who has been around forever, she is doing a,
how exciting,
a Danny Armstrong, what is this? Oh, it's okay. Danny he's
Armstrong,
he's the singer.
Siebert.
Yeah. Oh. So they're going to just.
We have pictures with that guy.
Yes,
I love that guy.
So they're playing at the Royal Cuckoo Organ Lounge next Friday, and that is 8 to 11. And that's in San Francisco. And I believe the Royal Cuckoo is her brother's bar. Yeah, I haven't been able to make it yet. I will do one Friday. I'm going to go.
I know, gonna, we need like, to do that.
Yeah,
and then just stay over.
We can stay at Tony's.
Okay.
Yay. Yeah, so that'll be fun. And they do do a music also at the Deluxe, which is a very small venue.
Very intimate.
It's tiny,
we've talked about it before.
But, this Friday they're going to be over at the Royal Cuckoo Lounge, which they play a lot. Because, you know.
Listen to this.
And then on the 22nd also, there's Blues at Shady from 9 to 12. I don't know if that's...
Oh, yay. That sounds fun.
Oh, it is. It's
The Hucklebucks.
Yeah, so the Hucklebucks are playing over at Shady. I mean, yeah, at Shady. So that's going to be... from 9 to 12.
I wish that Jason would put the shows on a little earlier because I'm old. I
9 to 12 is like...
I know, but I wish he'd start the music at 8 so that I could go home by 11. I'm old. Shut up.
She goes home by 11 when she wants to go home by 11.
But I want the music to start at 8 so I can see more of their music.
But then I'm
special
like...
Special request.
I like 9 because I'm always late anyway, so I'll be there at like 9:30 and I can still see the beginning of the show.
True.
On Sunday, good. On Sunday, Red's Blues Band is playing
which
from
is
2 to 5.
Which is Pieces and Parts of the Hucklebucks.
Yes.
Yeah.
Old and, well, Red's husband, RJ. RJ.
Dare.
No, RJ. He used to be in the Hucklebucks in the 90s.
Okay.
He played bass for them, so, yeah.
Oh, that'll be so, fun. At Sack Yard, which
Sack Yard from 2 to 5.
Okay.
So that'll be a fun afternoon
Always
if you're
fun
in Sacramento.
Sack Yard.
And then I think there's not, that's something that...
Okay. Hank Angel. I wish I was there.
I know.
I wish I was in Canada.
Yeah, we can't see Hank Angel, but...
No. He needs to come play Sacramento for real.
Yeah, but that show's on the 28th. At 17 Mile Pub. So, in Canada, right?
Road trip.
Soaky British Columbia.
Fabulous.
So, anyway, there's not a lot going on. I might, you know, Momo might have something at the Bourbon and Blues this Wednesday.
Oh, which I heard Alice Cantu is going to be playing the Bourbon and Blues in July.
Oh, awesome.
We're excited about that.
We love that.
I know. Finally,
that's exciting,
it happened.
Yeah.
Finally. Yeah, I saw Mindy at Cactus Pete, which I know we've talked about Cactus Pete, but that's a lot of fun on a Tuesday night if you're in town. You can go see really great vintage 78s at the Hideaway.
Ooh. Yeah. So, I think that's all of the stuff that's going on. We hope to see everyone at
Dad's Nostalgic. Yeah. Pinup Contest Barbecue.
Oh, my nails aren't painted. I shouldn't be showing you guys that.
I know, mine aren't either. I did a lot of gardening.
I'm
going to
wait until next week.
I know.
I'm like going to save it. I'm all, oh my God, my nails look horrible. They never looked that bad.
They were trash. I pulled up all the weeds in my garden this week. So,
again, we're super excited for all of the LA bands that are coming, our Sacramento bands that are going to be there, Elvis and the Fortunate Few. And, the pinup contest should be exciting. It's, you know, I hope the ladies, you know, bring it. They should.
They're going to. We have a beautiful contest all lined up. And Cherry Delicious, the hostess, and she's going to be amazing. She's always amazing. And it's going to be really fun. But yeah, so Dad's Nostalgic next Saturday. Bring your ride out. I think the cutoff was yesterday for the, if you wanted to pre-register your car. So now you just bring your car out. We'll register you at the door. Your wristband is all access. You can hang out all day, all night. We go till 2 o'clock in the morning. So drink your Red Bull, drink your Starbucks,
and
whatever.
And so I forget who asked about the waist training, but if you want to go, I know it's because we're just like, you know, we didn't have our shit together today.
No.
Anyway, I buy my corsets from Orchard Corsets. They're reasonable, and I really, really like them. And also, this dress, I'm sure some of you ladies know.
Yeah. Ah,
it is a Bernie Dexter.
So cute.
But I have to tell you guys, okay?
Okay.
So, Bernie Dexter sometimes has a really good sale.
Oh.
And I got two dresses for $100-ish.
That's really amazing.
70% off, ladies.
Ooh.
So, yeah, hashtag I was super excited. Dexter. So, this is new. So I've wanted this one for a long time, but you know her dresses are like almost $200.
Yeah.
So, and you can get two for
$100. That's a deal and a steal.
That is.
Yay.
So, yeah, Orchard Corsets, if you sign up, they send you discounts all the time, like to buy different corsets. Sometimes, you know, 10%, sometimes 20%. Sometimes they have sales. If you're into waist training, I would suggest start there.
Awesome.
It's a pretty reasonable website. So
nice.
Yeah.
And I guess we could just wrap it all up by saying, if you guys have any shows you want us to shout out or talk about, feel free to please private message us on Instagram. We are Wine Women and Song Gals on Instagram. We're Wine Women and Song on YouTube, which you'll see this video shortly on YouTube. We also have personal Instagram and Facebook accounts, so you can message us that way. I guess the biggest push, though, like we always say every week, is this, we need you to subscribe on the YouTube. So it's Wine Women and Song on the YouTube. And if you can subscribe, we're trying really hard to get to that 1,000 mark, which you guys know that's like the golden number. So
we would love to share some of our videos with you as we're talking, as we're, you know.
Yeah, we'll get there. We'll get there.
So we need you to subscribe to the YouTube.
The YouTube. Subscribe to the YouTube, if you would, please.
Yes.
But yeah, so we're just trying to get to that 1,000 people mark. If you can subscribe, tell your friends if you enjoy what we're talking about.
2,000, 3,000.
Who? Whatever.
Sky's the limit.
I mean. Dream big. Dream big. But if you like this kind of, you know, if you like the content, we'd love to hear from you. If you have suggestions, we'd love to hear from you. If you have shows you want us to talk about, we'd love to hear from you.
We don't care if they're not in Sacramento.
No, I mean, we...
Because we do
everywhere.
Cover all of California. We'll even talk about stuff overseas.
If you want to send us some
flyers,
albums, flyers,
music,
CDs,
so
we
hit us
won't
up.
Be able to play them as we're talking because we don't have that.
Yeah,
we
only
do
have
the vinyl.
Yeah.
But yeah, if you want to send us some CDs because that's all you have, we can talk about your music because we'll listen
to
it.
And we'll review it for you.
Absolutely.
And same thing if you're a person who maybe has, you know, some knowledge or has a product in the area of the local booze. We're always looking for things to review and drink and try. So send us your suggestions because we love to hear from you. So
yeah.
Really excited. This is good. I'm so sorry I was late today. She never starts without me. Usually
just
we're
like,
just late.
There's like people that were like, oh, okay, today. And I'm like, oh, okay.
Okay, well, that's good. I know I need to be more on time.
Well, it happens. I mean, things happen.
I'm on Mexican
Sunday.
Time.
That's right.
That's right.
You know, what are you going to do? What are you going to do? She's worth the wait anyway. She's worth the wait.
Am I really, though?
Totally. Yes. Yes,
absolutely. And I washed my hair today. So that's why I was kind of like, oh, I'm like
it's
trying
hard.
To tease it. I'm company. Trying to make, because it was
really
going
good.
Flat. And I was like.
This little swoop you got going is gorgeous.
Thanks.
Yep.
Swoop. Yeah, I didn't want to do the bumper today.
No, it's really good. I love it. I love
it. Fake pony because I've done that all weekend. So I was kind of over it.
The
and
weather.
I needed to wash my hair. Well, it was so hot. I was wearing my hair up in a
scarf.
Yeah.
That's, restaurant does us.
I think she's done with her wine.
I drank it. I drank it.
Some of mine, so
oh, look, Jersey
Cheers.
Okay. Cheers, you guys. Listen.
Happy Sunday fun day.
Happy
guys.
Father's Day, all you daddies.
Yeah,
really appreciate
yay.
You.
Happy
and
Father's
I
Day.
I hope you really enjoy your time.
Yes.
And yeah, definitely hit us up. And we will see you next Sunday at 1 o'clock.
We
always
will.
Sunday at 1 o'clock. We'll be here. We're going to be like so tired next week, though. How are we even going to manage? We may be actually like still on the barroom floor at the Wrangler bar.
We have one eyelash up here
yeah.
and our makeup is
only
Robert
one eyebrow,
Smith out.
And it's like
yeah,
hair's
one
on.
Eyebrow. Just forgive us because we
gonna
are going to have
can.
So much fun.
We're
we might end
up
partying up. Later with all those like LA
all of our
crews.
LA
yes, yay.
Yeah. So join us at Dad's
yeah.
if you can. In the meanwhile, we'll see you next week, 1 o'clock. Definitely PM us. We'd love to hear from you.
Yeah,
and thank
absolutely.
You again so much for being with us. We'll see you next week.
Thank you.
Love, love, love. Smooches.
Cheers.
Mwah.